So today's video is going to be my July favorites. Freaking July. Oh my god. We've been doing quarantine since March. Like the start of March. March, April, May, June, July. We are coming on 6 months of
this hell.
I just want this to end. I want us to wake up one day and then Corona's gone and the memory of Corona's gone. Like we wake up and it's like it never happened. That's what I want. How many monthly favorites videos are we gonna do before we get to the end of this tunnel? I don't know. Stay tuned. But I gotta be honest, when it comes to trying out new products, where am I going? I would love to test out a foundation for like 12 hours when I'm out and about, but where am I going? And don't get me wrong, you know I've always been the I never leave my house type, but I really never leave my house now. Like unless I have to, doctor, vet, grocery store, maybe. Unless I absolutely have to leave my house, I'm not going anywhere. So I'm gonna walk you through all my favorite products I've been loving in the month of July, and I've been enjoying them from the inside of these walls. Okay, so my first favorite is on theme of what we were just discussing. I have bought more hand sanitizer in the last 4 months than I've ever had in my entire life. And I have really loved to see so many brands come out with their own versions of hand sanitizer. My favorite is the Touchland hand sanitizer. It's the one I use as my phone in all my TikToks. That's my favorite hand sanitizer because it comes in a spray form and I love spray hand sanitizers. I hate the little whoop. I can't do those anymore. The Bath & Body Works hand sanitizers, I just can't do them anymore. I love the convenience of a spray and I've spoken about that other hand sanitizer in a favorites video before, but I recently got this one in the mail and oh my gosh, this is the best hand sanitizer I've ever used. If you are a fan of Sol de Janeiro, at least if you're a fan of that classic Sol scent, oh, like their bum bum cream, you know, the Sol de Janeiro scent. It's like the best freaking scent. It's so yummy. It smells like caramel and it smells like heaven. It really does. And the fact that they made it into a hand sanitizer is truly amazing. But not only is the scent really great, this is actually a really moisturizing hand sanitizer. I love how it feels. You can spray it all over your hands and it doesn't dry out your hands, not even in the slightest. Like it almost feels like you applied a very, 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 very lightweight, easily absorbed hand cream. I said ham cream. It's just so nice. It's such a nice hand sanitizer and it leaves your hands smelling amazing. It doesn't stay smelling amazing all day, but it's such a pleasure to spray throughout the day. I love this little thing. I mainly use it when I go out in public, so I haven't been using it like crazy. I went to the vet the other day and I was like with my mask on and my gloves, but it smells so good that I still even spray it around the house. I'm like, it's so yummy. This is definitely a cheap favorite because I haven't been using it that long, but oh my gosh, I have completely fallen in love with the new Colourpop Pretty Fresh Hyaluronic Hydrating Foundation. I don't know what it is about this, but it's so good. It leaves your skin looking fresh and beautiful the entire day. If you're a fan of the Pretty Fresh Tinted Moisturizer, I feel like you would love the foundation. It's pretty much the same thing, only with more coverage. It kind of leaves a smoother, more satin-like finish to the skin. It's not as dewy, it's not as liquidy. It's more like foundation-y. It's literally that. The other one is more moisturizing. It's a tinted moisturizer, and this is more foundation-y. It's honestly the exact formula I would picture for a Pretty Fresh foundation. I was pleasantly surprised. For some reason, I was like, oh, it's not gonna be as good as the tinted moisturizer. Watch it suck. I don't know why I felt like I was not gonna like it, but I ended up really, really loving it. I'm currently using the shade Light 70W, even though it's a little bit too deep for me, but I have been using this gradual tanner that I bought the other day, and yeah. So it's gonna balance out here in a second. But definitely check this out if you've been wanting to test out a new foundation. I love this. I'm wearing it on my skin right now. I've been wearing it for hours. I freaking love it. I love this blush so much. This is from the brand 3CE. I mentioned this brand in my full face of Korean makeup video, but it is a K-beauty brand and I absolutely love everything I test out from this brand. I love their packaging and I really, really like their formulas. This blush specifically has been one of my go-to blushes recently. I love this. It's so creamy and yummy. I kind of love it for the same reason that I loved the Beauty Bakery blush that I think I spoke about in my last month's favorite. It gives your skin that really pretty like sun-kissed pinky peach vibe. Like it's a pink, but it has a really pretty warm undertone that just looks stunning on the cheeks. And this is my favorite kind of matte formula. It's so creamy. Like when you put your finger in this, it almost feels like a cream. It's such a beautiful matte. Honestly, the formula on this is wonderful. I don't know how to explain it, but if blushes were hydrating, like if blushes could be hydrating, if matte blushes could be hydrating, this is my idea of a hydrating matte blush. Because it's not flat, it's not chalky, it gives life to the cheeks. Most matte blushes are a little bit powdery and chalky. This one's great, and it is pretty affordable. I think I got mine on Amazon, if I'm not mistaken. I want them all. I want all of these blushes. They're so good. Okay, let's talk about my go-to lips for the past month, and they're all very similar. My number one lip liner, you guys know, you guys saw this coming, this freaking chair. The Alamar Cosmetics birthday suit lip liner has become one of my favorite lip liners of all time. The formula of the Alamar lip liners are really nice. They last a super long time on the lips and they glide really easily. So if you wanted to like overdraw your lips, it's really easy with this lip liner. And this color is so freaking pretty. I'm wearing it on my lips right now. I have a lipstick on top, but I love pairing this lip liner with any pinky nude under the sun. It's such a good pinky nude. If you want a warm nude, like a very brownish kind of nude, I would recommend Dulce from Alamar, but Birthday Suit is the perfect pinky nude lip liner ever. Like ever, 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 ever. I have to scream it from the rooftops. It's such a freaking amazing lip liner. And I just want to mention the lip gloss really quick, even though I know this is sold out, so I feel so bad mentioning it. But the Birthday Suit lip gloss from Alamar is so good. She needs to make this permanent. I don't know what she was thinking making this limited edition. She had her mind. This is the best lip gloss she has. Out of all of the colors she's made, this is the best one. This combo is the best lip combo ever. Like it is, it's my go-to nude lip. That lip liner, this gloss, so freaking good. Please put this back in stock, Gabby, because it's like the perfect pinky shimmery amazingness and everybody needs it, so bring it back. So as you know, my addiction to shiny lipsticks keeps growing. My shiny lipstick collection keeps growing. I wanna wear jutsy, shiny, glossy lipsticks for the rest of my life. I love these types of lipsticks, especially when they're like lighter shades, like nudes or light pinks or browns, like on the lighter side, because they just look so sheer and yummy and I love it. And I have been super loving the new Fenty Beauty ones. They're the sheer shiny lipsticks, and these two are my favorite colors. This is Makeout Break. This is when I want a super, super, super nude. And then I have been loving Glazed. It's the one I'm wearing on my lips right now. It's such a juicy, yummy, pinky nude that feels incredible on the lips. Yeah, it's not the most long-wearing lipstick, like you're gonna have to reapply throughout the day, but it's a shiny lipstick. It's not like a super matte liquid lipstick that's meant to be bulletproof. This has some slip to it, but it's not greasy. It's not gonna like go all over your lips or like travel down your throat. It's a really nice lipstick. I love the formula on these, and they smell like heaven. Oh my gosh, like honestly the best smelling lipsticks ever. Oh my gosh, so good. Like a yummy vanilla, kind of like the MAC lipsticks, but a little bit sweeter. Really good. And then I wanted to just quickly mention the Sephora Lip Stories lip balm thing. They're called the Brilliant Shine Lip Stories Balms. They're really, really good. I want to buy so many more shades. They're very similar to the Fenty Beauty formula. They're just like really beautiful, shiny lipsticks. This one in the shade Ditching Class has a little bit of like a sheen to it, and it looks stunning on the lips. I just love how healthy these make your lips look, and it also gives you a little bit of color. So you get that shine, but you get that pigment. It's really, really nice, and I'm just addicted to these kinds of formulas. I love them. I have found my new favorite acne treatment gel, like acne spot treatment gel. This is the Fab Pharma BHA Acne Spot Treatment Gel with 2% salicylic acid. It's safe for sensitive skin, and it is truly amazing. The other day I had a freaking rhinoceros on my forehead, and I just stabbed a little bit of this right on top of it, and when I woke up the next day, my rhinoceros turned into like a little puppy. It was so much smaller. Still there, but it's a little puppy. It's a little, little puppy. And I was just blown away. I've loved so many of these treatments in the past. Like, I really liked the Origins one for a long time. But this one I felt did the job without drying out my skin. Sometimes you'll have, like, a ring of dryness around your pimple when you use other, like, stronger treatments. This one was excellent, but it wasn't drying on my skin. I really, really loved it. And it's good. I've been putting it on, like, my little pimples that pop up here and there, especially around that time of the month. And it's awesome. It definitely, like, cuts those bad boys in half. I love First Aid Beauty. It's one of my favorite skincare brands. Okay, I know I have been promising a curly girl video for a long time. Oh my God, I've been doing like the curly girl journey as long as quarantine pretty much, because I believe March is when I was like, you know what? I'm not gonna iron my hair like that anymore. I can't believe it's almost been 6 months since I don't really flat iron my hair. Oh my God, the time Time flies, man. Time flies when you're not having fun and you're sitting home alone all the time and haven't seen your friends or family in months. Time flies. Anyway, I know I've been promising a curly girl video for a long time, but I really want to test out so many products. I want to make sure that when I'm recommending my favorite products, I've tried a ton of them, you know? And one of the ones I've been really, really loving is the Curlsmith Hydro Style Flexi Jelly. This is really, really great if you have very frizzy hair. The biggest thing for me when it comes to my curly hair is my frizz. I find that so many products that say it's anti-frizz is not. I live in Miami, I'm aware. I walk outside for 5 seconds and my hair is like this. I look like Hagrid if I'm outside for 2 seconds. It's almost impossible to keep my hair tamed when it's like naturally curly when I'm outside. It's impossible. But I love being outdoors. I like doing most of my work outside. I'll just like be on my computer and I'll be sitting outside. I like to be with nature, so I'm outside a lot. So I deal with frizz a lot. And honestly, if you have curly hair and you've tried something that has tamed your frizz, please let me know in the comments below. I wanna try everything. I am willing to try anything for my frizz. But this actually doesn't claim to do anything for your frizz, but I find that it really does help me tame my frizz. This is pretty much hair gel, but it's a really, really great lightweight hair gel that gives you a very strong hold. It says that it's like on a scale of 1 to 10, it's like a 7 when it comes to the hold. Like, it will leave your hair crunchy, but once you run your fingers through it and you start to like finger comb your hair, it creates such nice, shiny, frizz-free curls. I love this. It's one of my favorite gels that I've tried out. I'm still ride or die for my Curl Talk mousse from Not Your Mother's, but I've been loving so many of the Curlsmith products as well. They have really great ingredients. This one has hyaluronic acid, green tea, organic lavender, mashed amla. I don't know what that is, but looks good. But yeah, check this out if you have curly hair or like wavy hair and you really want to get the most out of your curls. It's a really nice lightweight hair product that's not going to weigh your hair down, because I have very fine hair and my hair can look weighed down really easily. This is a super nice like lightweight gel that defines the curls really nicely. So just want to mention that. Speaking of being outside a lot, I have found a new best friend. This is the Supergoop Glow Stick Sunscreen SPF 50. This thing is amazing. It's literally a freaking stick. Rub it all over your face and boom, you have SPF 50. And I don't use this as like my first step whenever I'm going outside. Like, for example, if I'm gonna do a pool day, like I will obviously apply SPF on my entire body and then I'll dive right in. But then like 2 hours later, I will go in with this guy and I'll just like rub this all over myself. It's so convenient. I literally leave this by the pool and I just grab it and rub it on, versus having to like pump something out or like wait until you're completely dry. And it gives me a super dewy, shiny glow. My skin looks more youthful because of the shine. I look like a 21-year-old in the pool. And the best part is that it has a high SPF. It's SPF 50, so it's amazing. I love reapplying it all over my face when it's hot and sunny outside. Okay, and then my last favorite is kind of a random one, but I have been obsessed with my dry brush. I guess it's called like dry brushing? No. Dry brushing? I've been obsessed with using this on my body, and a part of me always thinks like, okay, this could be a gimmick, this could be really silly, but I really enjoy doing this. I truly enjoy doing this. If you don't know, a dry brush is used to like exfoliate your skin, and you kind of use it in like circular motions. You start at your feet and you start like rubbing in circular motions all the way up to your heart, they say. And I really love using this, especially on my thighs and like my butt area. This is really great for exfoliating. It's supposed to, what is it called? It's called lymphatic drainage. I'm not super skilled on that. I'm just now learning about this kind of thing, but I just love the experience. It like removes all your dead skin cells. It's great for blood circulation, and I've been using it for about a month now, and I feel like it's part of my routine. They recommend you use this before your morning shower. So like in the morning, I'll get up and I'll do like a quick workout, and right before I will take a shower to like wash my body, I'll just like rub this all over my body before I jump in the shower. And I don't know, I truly love using this, and I love how it makes my skin feel, especially on my legs and my thighs and my butt. And so yeah, I picked mine up at Sana Skin Studio. It's like a little skincare studio here in Miami. Well, I mean, I bought it online. They do have a website. You should totally check them out, Sana Skin. They have the most beautiful skincare on their website. They have a ton of different brands on their website. I actually bought my toner that I have been obsessed with, like my spray toner that I talked about in my last video. I bought it off the Sana Skin website. They just have like really, really, really great skincare and body products, so check them out. Swear I bought this bad boy. But yeah, guys, that's it. I want to do a quick shout out to my earrings, because I literally think these are the prettiest freaking baby hoops I've ever seen. Don't these earrings remind you of old vintage glam? Like old Hispanic vintage glam. I'm obsessed.
them.
This is part of the new August CO bag, which the theme for the bag this month is Lady Venus. It came with this gorgeous bracelet. This ring is absolutely stunning. It's a heart with a pearl. This month is so romantic, I cannot. I just quickly wanted to mention that because I'm really, really obsessed with these earrings. I mainly wanted to shout out the earrings. And yeah, that's it. That completes this video. These were all the products I was absolutely loving in the month of July. Don't forget to leave me a comment down below letting me know what you were loving in July. Oh, by the way, I'm super late on my favorites video this month. I didn't realize what day it was. This happened last month. The days are mashing together, guys. My months are forming into one. Where is the time going? But anyway, guys, that completes this video. I love you guys so, so, so much. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you in my next video. Bye. Do I have scratches on my lens?
Or is that dirty?
Oh dear, that was dirty this whole time.